Welcome back to another episode of me picking things up and putting them down again. Today, I will be explaining how to fit a full body workout into under 45 minutes because gyms are still not fully open here, as well as a 225-pound deadlift go me and a riveting discussion at the end of free weights versus machines. Smash the thumbs up button if you're liking the video, hit the subscribe button, and we're gonna hop straight into the workout because I lost my intro clip when I deleted stuff off my SD card. Woo! Welcome to the warm-up of our workout. So, first off, we are starting off with a triset. Now, as you guys may or may not know, a usual triset goes exercise A, B, C, and then rest. So you do three exercises back to back and then rest. Because I am programming basically all compound lifts, aka very difficult lifts, in my exercises A, B, and C slots, I am putting a minute rest between each of those exercises to give my central nervous system and my body full time to recover. So I'm doing exercise A, then rest, exercise B, then rest, exercise C, then rest, and I'm repeating that four times. The three exercises I chose were the squat, overhead press, and bend to over row. I chose them because they don't interfere with each other because they're all different muscle groups, you know what I'm saying? So here we are just getting the joints lubricated. Oops, I hate that word, I am so sorry. We're just getting blood flow to the muscles, you know what I'm saying? Like we're getting things going, so to speak, in the body. I kind of knew my weight on the squat and overhead press. I knew I was going to be squatting 135. I knew I was going to be overhead pressing 55, but I wasn't quite sure on the bent over row because I don't remember what my bent over row was at before gyms closed. So I was like, I'm just going to go throw 25 pounds on each side of that bit, you know what I'm saying, over the 5 pounds that were already there for my overhead squat, for a total of 105 pounds. And we're just going to watch this go. And like, it did not go, y'all. So yeah, my bent over row way overshot it, and I had to settle back down to 10s on each side plus the 5s. Here we are going through the actual triset. Here are some cues to think about with each of these exercises. With the bent over row, basically you are trying to keep your elbows pinched at your sides when you are rowing up as much as possible. So if you take your elbows out wide when you're doing a row, you're basically moving the movement to more of an upper back movement. And I wanted this movement to be much more lat focused, which means keeping the elbows in close to the sides. By the way, guys, my lats are one of my favorite muscle groups on the human body. I just think they're dope AF because, first of all, they're what lets you do pull-ups. But second of all, they also give you those wings on your back. You know what I'm saying, ladies? We want the wings because then you look like you have like an hourglass figure. Does that make sense? Okay, whatever. Let's focus on the pull-ups part. That part is very cool. On the overhead press, your main objective with the overhead press is to have the barbell be as straight up and down as possible. So you're starting it at your shoulders and you're pressing straight up. Now, while you're doing that, your head is going to come forward a little bit at the very top. And people call it bringing your head through the window because you kind of make a window with your arms when they're fully extended. So it kind of looks like you're taking your head from back to facing front, if that makes sense. I don't know how to explain it, but you guys will see when I do it that your head kind of like goes out and in as you overhead press. And with most barbell movements, guys, the barbell should very rarely be moving out in front of you. It should usually be going up and down. With deadlifts, it's going up and down. With squats, it's going up and down. With overhead press, same thing, it's going up and down. The further away the barbell gets from your body, first of all, the higher risk of injury, and second of all, it gets exponentially heavier the farther away it goes. I don't like really know the physics behind that. I'm sure there's an equation where you could calculate exactly how much heavier it is. But I'm pretty sure someone said like for every inch away from your body, add like, was it 40% of the weight or 15% of the weight? I don't remember. The point is it gets heavier the further away it is from your body and you're begging for an injury. So keep it in close, keep it in a straight line. And if it's not going in a straight line, there's probably something up with your form. And the last thing I want to talk about is the squat. I am not particularly proud of my squat form. I don't think it's the greatest, but things to keep in mind with the squat are what position is most comfortable for you, high bar or low bar. I am a high bar squatter as of right now. And really the weight distribution on your feet is, I think, the biggest key when it comes to the squat. The weight should kind of be in the middle of your foot. It shouldn't be super in the front. It shouldn't be super in the back. Your knees should not be going in a different line than your toes. I know people get really worried about their knees going over your toes, but something even more important is that your knees are going in the exact same line as your toes. So that is going to be what prevents injury the most, because your knee should be tracking in the same direction of your toes. And then if you want to involve a little bit more glute, you can turn your toes out a little bit, so your knees will also travel out a little bit. And now we are moving on to my second kind of group of exercises, which was a superset. So as you guys know, a superset is two exercises back to back. And of course, I chose the deadlift and bench press. The bench press is a little less of a duh. I don't particularly care about my bench press, but you guys, could I have a workout without including a deadlift? It's like my jam. It's my bread and butter. It's my favorite exercise. I was really feeling a 225 in me today. Yes, I haven't been to the gym for 5 weeks. Yes, I have tendonitis, but you know what my brain said to me? It said, Yuna, today's a 225 type of day. And upon further reflection, this may not have been the best idea, because when I actually did do the 225, first of all, I hadn't warmed up properly. I had only warmed up with 135. And second of all, it just felt like really heavy. I was gonna go for 4 reps. I actually only did 3 and I was like, I don't even know if I can do this. This is me benching 95. So those are my working sets for the day. I really was contemplating, like, did I overstretch myself? Am I gonna be able to finish these 4 sets? But I actually did finish them, even though they almost killed me, which is exciting for me personally.
I think that was what that feels like.
Some form things to keep in mind when you're doing deadlifts is to alternate your grip if you are using switch grip, because if you're always doing one hand a certain way and one hand the other way, you're going to get some strange imbalances in your bicep and traps and like weird stuff that you don't want. And in the bench press, I don't really have, oh, I do have a lot of form cues. Okay, your butt needs to be like taped to the bench, like cemented to the bench. Your feet need to be pushing into the floor as much as possible, and your shoulders need to be anchored to the bench. So the only part that's not like anchored to the bench is your lower back, which a lot of people like to arch when they're doing the bench press. Then in my final set of deadlifts, guys, I decided to go for it and try for 4 instead of 3, because I was just like, last set, best set, time to really push yourself. And so I did, and I got 4, and I was really, really proud of myself, because it was really hard and I was exhausted, especially on the last set.
OMG, can you believe? I will tell you and I will tell them that I did 225. I guess they already know because they already saw it. But can you believe that I did 225? Can I get a round of applause for wearing a tank top in the snow? Woo! Round of applause. Oh my God, I'm so happy. That was so brutal. Oh, this is the place with the nice lighting. Do you guys like lighting?
That's stuff I want to talk to you about, but not with you guys around.
I have to talk to her. Stop hogging all her time.
Well, here's the thing. What do you call when you're just training with weights? Is it like free weights or weights in free air?
Free weights are like dumbbells and barbells. Yeah, yeah,
yeah. It's like the first time that I've used the machines.
Yeah.
And honestly, like, it was so much easier. Like, my form was so much better.
Here's what I say on this whole discussion. Obviously, I prefer the free weights, because I will tell you why. The machines are actually invented for people to use for physical therapy.
Yes, so that's me.
It was if people, like, you know, if you didn't want to get injured or use other body parts and stuff, or like you had something wrong so you only want to train that one part, then they would use the machines. But then people started using them all the time because they are a lot easier. So like, you don't have to use any of your stabilizer muscles. Like Nancy said, there's a lot less room to screw up. It forces you into only one like plane of movement, first of all. So like, a lot of the time that's not even the proper way for somebody's body to move if your body doesn't exactly fit the machine. But yeah, it is a lot easier. And fun fact, that is how I started working out personally. So if the Yuna Gjata started off on machines, then what Nancy was just saying, guys, is that because she's had an unfortunate time off the gym,
yeah,
I don't know what to call it.
So sad.
Because she's had a bit of a, let's say, a deload period, deload month.
Paradise vacation.
She had to just use the little nubbin and not use any of the weights. But look, did she still go to the gym?
Yeah, against my will.
Anyways, what I was gonna say was, can we all get a round of applause for Nancy training upper body, even though she hates upper body? They're all clapping.
So I was gonna say,
clap at your computers. Oh, thanks for watching. Subscribe, like the video, notification bell, comment. Bye.